Did you tell me before going on that PC skirt?
Jesus Christ.
Did you seek for my consent before? With peace. Good morning, sir.
Mirabel.
Jerry.
There is no food in the kitchen. Where's my breakfast?
Are you seriously asking me for your breakfast?
Should I go and ask the neighbors?
No, why ask the dogs? Look, we're just cohabiting. That's what we're doing. I'm not here as your wife. The earlier you get that, the better for us both.
Mirabel, is this how you want us to live in this house? Is that what you want?
My darling, I'm just following suit. You started this whole mess yourself. So I'm following your lead. If you want to eat, go into the kitchen, cook yourself something to eat. I'm not your maid, I'm not your servant. Do you get that? In the absence of any other thing, I think I'm enjoying my meal. You just came here to ruin my moments. So just get out and...
Okay. I'm sure you know you did not marry a lazy man. Hmm? My mother actually taught me how to cook. So I can go in there and make myself a nice little meal. Okay?
Watch Jeremiah, me do it. Don't spit into my coffee.
Oh, shut up.
Do yourself the honors already. Your mother thought you were on your blabbing because you did not see your coffee.
I know how you feel. And you have every right to feel that way. You do all the considering, all the warning. She's your wife regardless. You know how she is. She's a very stubborn person. Until she comes to that point of realization, nothing you say is going to make any sense to her.
Jenny, honestly speaking, I am tired. At this point, I don't care anymore. You see, if Mirabel wants to leave this house today, I will gladly open the door for her. I'm telling you.
Don't even say that. Why would you do something like that? She's your wife.
Yes, she's my wife and I am her husband. Am I not? Why does it feel like I'm the only person fighting for this? Huh? Mirabel would not even give me a listening ear. Every time, I'm just tired. I'm tired of begging. I'm tired of pleading. I'm just so tired.
I don't know what two of you are doing, but this marriage is not breaking, okay? Because I won't let it happen. You're the best person for my friend. And my friend is the best person for you. It's just that there is just this missing link. I don't know what to call it.
Jenny, I'm not a bad person. And trust me, Mirabel isn't a bad person either. I don't know. Maybe we're not just compatible.
Don't even go there. You're not compatible and you've been together all this time. You're just discovering now that you are not compatible. You are compatible, okay? It's just that you people, I don't know, Mirabel is allowing evil get in the way. You don't want to sit down and talk like two adults?
Are you kidding me, Jenny? You're sounding as if you don't know your friend. Like I've been proposing this for ages, but she can't even stand me. Mirabel would not give me a listening ear. In fact, Mirabel cannot make one full sentence without insulting me. She calls me dog, sheep, everything. What am I supposed to do? She wouldn't listen to me.
I know you didn't do anything, okay? I know you've been patient, but just a little more patient, please. Don't ruin this beautiful thing that the two of you have.
Yeah. That's if she's also willing not to let the so-called beautiful thing to die off. What am I going to do?
Your people will use your stubbornness and ego to spoil this relationship. But you see me, I'm not listening and I'm not backing down. I am not letting either of you go. This must be paid up. This marriage will stand whether you like it or not. And it is final.
Jenny. Thank you so much, though. Thank you. Anyway, thank you. That's why you're always my go-to. Anyway, thank you. I have to get back to work, okay?
All right.
Bye. Where are you coming from by this time of the night?
I went out. I'm coming back from where I went to.
Mirabe, I'm not joking with you. So I need you to start answering me right now. I said, where the hell are you coming from by this time?
Do I look like a comedian? I said I went out and I'm just coming back.
This is an ungodly hour for a married woman to be coming back home. It's 11:25 p.m. for crying out loud. Have you no shame?
Married woman. Oh, am I married?
Excuse you?
Oh, I forgot. You know, you have to remind me. Look, you are no longer in charge of telling me what to do. Okay? You lost that right. You can't tell me what to do, how to do it, when to do it, where to do it. You can't. Like I said, you lost the right. So excuse me.
Mirabel. This is my house. Okay? And last time I checked, you're still my wife. And as long as we remain like that, you will tell me where you're going to and when you're coming. What is all this now?
You lie. I'm not telling you nothing. Look, I just went out to unwind. I went out to have fun. If you'd excuse me, I want to go and rest. Did you tell me before going under PC's skirt?
Jesus Christ.
Did you seek for my consent before? With peace? Did you?
Can you just make one sentence without involving peace in this conversation? Huh?
No, I can't. Because peace has stolen my peace. Capisce? Good night.
Mirabel.